Hello everyone, this is the first video in our special relativity series. So in this lesson we're going to cover two of the Einstein's postulates that are the basis for his theories. Einstein's first postulate has to do with inertial frames of reference. So he stated that the laws of physics are the same in all inertial frames of reference. In other words, the measurements in one inertial reference frame, like time, position, and velocity, can be converted to measurements in another by simple transformation. Just to remember, an inertial reference frame is that reference frame that's not accelerating. In other words, is at rest or at constant speed, right? Relative to another reference frame. If you have any doubts about inertial reference frames, I recommend you to watch our previous video on Newton's first law. So to better understand Einstein's first postulate, let's take a look into this example here. Here we have two inertial reference frames. S0, this guy here is standing still, okay, he's not moving. And this another reference frame, S1, is moving at a constant speed. It's the guy in the car here, okay? So both reference frames are inertial because they're not accelerating, okay? So let's analyze the movement of the second car here according to both reference frames. Well, according to Einstein, we can apply the laws of physics on both reference frames. Okay, they will be the same. So when the cars start moving, according to S0, it moved this distance here, x0. But according to S1, because it was moving along with the car at a lower speed, okay, it only moved x1. So the first postulate says that we can convert both measurements by a simple transformation. And that's true, right? Because the laws of physics apply for both reference frames. So we can say that this distance here is actually the velocity, the speed of the car, times the time it took to get here. So x1 is x0 minus this distance, which is u times t. That's what we call the Galilean transformation, and it works for speeds that are much lower than the speed of light. Okay, so this the first postulate has to do with the reference frames. Now Einstein's second postulate has to do with the speed of light, and he said that the speed of light is a constant independent of the relative motion of the source. And in fact, the speed of light in vacuum is 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. And this is the highest speed we can get in our universe. Just remember, this is the speed of light in vacuum. You can watch our video on the refraction of light, and you see that this speed here depends on the medium the light is, okay? So this is for vacuum. And this brings some consequences, right? In the classic physics, if we have a car here and the person inside the car throws the ball in the direction of this other person here, so we have the speed of the car, 10 kilometers per hour, for example, and he throws the ball forward at a certain speed, 3 kilometers per hour, for example. So for this observer here, the speed of the ball will actually be 13 kilometers per hour, will be the speed of the car plus the speed of the ball. We are adding the speeds here, right? Now imagine we have this rocket now with a lantern above it. So the rocket is moving at a very high speed, very close to the speed of light, let's say 0.9 times the speed of light. And the light, of course, is a constant in the vacuum, right? So it's moving at the speed of light. So you might think that for this observer watching something like this, we can just add the velocities, right? So it's the speed of the rocket plus the speed of light would be 1.9 times the speed of light. But that's actually wrong, because the speed of the light is the limit we have, and it's a constant independent of the relative motion of the source. So for this case, this guy here, this observer, would see the speed of the light as the speed of the light, okay? That's the limit. Now here's a situation for you guys to think about. We have three observers, okay, A, B, and C. Observer A is traveling on top of this rocket here at 0.9 times the speed of light and is flashing a light towards observer B. Now observer B is going the opposite direction at 0.8 times the speed of light. So I want you to think, what would be the speed of the light for the three observers A, B, and C? Okay, think about it, think about Einstein's postulates we've seen in this lesson, and write your answers in the comment section. See you later.
Now that you watched this video, you're one step closer to achieving your academic goals. Well done! There's always more to learn, so check out our other videos and don't forget to subscribe.